Hello, brains. Have you ever heard of the marshmallow test? Inhibition, noun, is the ability to feel an automatic impulse to do something and not act on it. It's an executive function that helps with self-control. Like if we see a balloon float past a window. Response inhibition is what allows us to choose not to pay attention to that balloon. Or yell, balloon! Or chase after the balloon. Basically, in a situation in which our brain's automatic response isn't helpful to our goals, response inhibition is what allows us to hit pause on that response and choose either to not respond or to respond in a way that's more adaptive. It's what helps us not be impulsive or get pulled off task by distractions. And response inhibition is impaired in ADHD. The term response inhibition is mostly used by researchers, so I have no idea how often any of us are actually going to use this term on a daily basis, but I do think it's helpful to know the term for it, because it's something that most of us do struggle with on a daily basis. Things like hearing a noise in the hallway while we're taking a test are more likely to make us lose focus because of poor response inhibition. We're more likely to have a hard time stopping in the middle of a sentence, even when we know what we're about to say isn't helpful to the situation. And when we're trying to accomplish a task, there's a lot more that can pull us away because our brains essentially aren't filtering those things out as irrelevant or unimportant. We're automatically responding to a lot more of them. This is why those with ADHD often need to rely on other ways to manage our impulses, like minimizing distractions or setting up cues and reminders that help us get back on task. Response inhibition is also one of the things that ADHD medication typically helps with a lot. If you'd like to learn more about response inhibition, there's a ton of research about it. I'll link to that in the description below. If you'd like to learn strategies that can help us stay on task, check out this playlist. This episode is sponsored by The Hero's Journal, which turns your goal into a quest. It was designed for ADHD brains by ADHD brains, and it's based on science and D&D nerdiness, all of which I really appreciate. So I was excited to try it out, and it was even better than I expected. The packaging is beautiful. The texture of the journal itself is really nice. The artwork is unique and progresses with you as you continue on your quest. It's clear a lot of love went into making this, and a lot of thought. The first few pages walk you through how to define your overall quest, and every day there's space to choose a quest for that day, something to move you toward your bigger quest. So I really love the focus on one overall quest while getting the novelty and variety of a daily quest to help us move toward it. I am just setting off on my quest, which is to build a life in line with my values, all of my values. Today's quest is to spend time with friends I haven't seen in a while. There's space for me to write out my schedule so I can visualize my time better and figure out how to make time to go see those friends. And there's even space for me to write out what might get in the way. I love that the pages are undated, so if we skip a few days, we can jump right back in. It even includes space for prioritizing the most important things we need to get done that day. All of this is designed to help us build a positive narrative about productivity, and I just realized I can totally color this. If you'd like to try the Hero's Journal or buy one for a friend, click on the link in the description below and use code HOWTOADHD. Thank you to my brain advocates and all my Patreon brains for helping me and my team stay on task. And for understanding when we don't. After all, letting ourselves get distracted and be impulsive sometimes can lend itself to creativity. Like, subscribe, click all the things, and I will see you next video. Bye, brains.